Hey guys, so this is a project that you can get super creative with and really try to make your own. It's all about choosing an art piece from a museum and recreating it. So you can always take objects from your house and use them in a creative way. Try to pick a classic art piece and get materials that you can use to recreate it. Alright, so here's my example. I chose The Shrine by, I'm going to butcher this pronunciation, Władysław Theodor Benda. It's found in the Polish Museum of America in Chicago.
Alright, so here I started gluing my eyebrows down because I saw this on RuPaul. This is how you get your eyebrows. This is pretty. You take like glue and then like powder and you put it over. So since her eyebrows are like a straight across, I thought this would be a good idea. It was pretty fun, not gonna lie, because I've never seen myself with eyebrows before. So yeah, just glue and powder. Yup. This is what it looks like when I don't have eyebrows. And so this is, I'm gonna recreate her eyebrows, which are just straight across, really thin. Times have changed. Yeah, these kind of eyebrows would be interesting in modern day. And they were, that's what was in her portrait. I don't know what to say. They look pretty insane, but I mean, they were fun, you know, that's part of recreating it. And so I took some white eyeliner that I had, and I tried to recreate the highlights of the photo since they're so drastic. I blended them out a bit. I have a couple like makeup tools to do that, and then I just sort of tried to add like the blush contours and the shadows where they were dramatically. It looks extreme, especially with the blush, because the blush is so crazy in the portrait, but It all makes sense. I just tried to recreate the portrait as best I could, so that meant some intense makeup. I used so much blush, it's crazy. But yeah, that's where this is going. Then I put some lipstick on because she has some seriously red lips, and it's all gonna come together eventually. She has some like, you know, some very specific hair, so I tried to pin it. And then I took I had some ribbon in my house, and so I tried to, like, you know, put that in the same way that it was in the portrait. I folded it in half and tied it. And once that was done, I didn't know what to do for some of the flowers. You can get as creative as you want with, like, materials, but I just figured I'd draw the flowers since I didn't have anything really orange in my house, so I took some paper and some markers because I have a lot of markers, and I tried to like create my own little versions of the flowers that were in her hair in the original portrait. And so once I was like done like coloring them in, I cut them out so I could put them in my hair. And once I cut them out, wait, hold on. Okay, yeah, no, I just put them in my hair and with the ribbon. And then I tried to reposition my hand so they'd look like the portrait. This was as close as I could get. Yep, this is that's my recreation. So, you know, you can get as crazy as you want. I thought it looked fun. I had fun making it. And so, for the next part, I wanted to do a subject that wasn't me, because I know that a lot of people wouldn't be comfortable doing makeup and stuff, so I get it. But, yeah, so I wanted to do another portrait, and so this is what I chose.
Alright, so for the second example that I had, I wanted to recreate a famous photograph entitled The Afghan Girl by Steve McCurry. And I wanted to do that with my cat, so it was on a cover of a 1985 issue of National Geographic. It's considered one of the most famous journalistic photographs of all time, and it was featured in a 2017 exposition in the Palais des Beaux-Arts in Belgium. I chose my cat to recreate this image since she also has such piercing green eyes. I thought it would be a really nice thing to do, so that's what I chose.
Alright, so I have a nasty little gremlin, and her name is Olive. She's sniping at me, as you can see. She didn't want to be photographed, but she's also beautiful, so there comes a price. So all they had to do was just kind of, you know, try to grab her to be photographed. Yeah, she tried to swipe at me, but, you know, I gave her some treats, and she calmed down a bit, so she became a really beautiful photo eventually. But yeah, so I had a shirt, and I thought that it would help, you know, make her look a little bit more photogenic. Put her in the shirt, she kind of struggled, and this was an interesting experience, I'm not gonna lie. I've never photographed my cat, but once I had her in the shirt, I took a tapestry, I patted her down, she calmed down, see? Yeah, she's good. And then here are some of the shots that I got of her in the tapestry. Yeah, she's freaking beautiful. But here is the final shot. The piercing green eyes. I can't get over how beautiful my final portrait is. I love it so much. But yeah, she really did recreate the same energy of the same photo, you know? So I had a lot of fun making this. If you don't want to do a portrait of just yourself, then you can always do someone else or another, like, you know, an animal, or you can do objects. It's totally up to you. I really encourage you guys to get as creative as you can. I appreciate the effort, and I hope that you all are doing really well. Keep being creative, and good luck on this project. I cannot wait to see what you guys come up with. So thank you. Bye.